presence of over 30 monuments, revolutionizing our understanding of Terra.
If you like, the library consists of 137
million. Who's playing over here?
See,
it
might take 7 years.
Easy.
Using conventional methods. It's a remarkable piece of work.
But LIDAR does have its limitations.
It's pretty not remarkable.
It only measures the surface of the ground.
It's a quercus plant or juncus. It's not doing very well. It's kind of yellow.
So Joe and his colleagues set about using more down-to-earth techniques to peer beneath the soil.
Still need moss.
Known as geophysics, they used a series of different instruments to measure the electrical and magnetic properties of the
ground. I call it
it's like taking
a fallen tree in the jungle.
During the course of the survey, you're completely unaware of the nature of the features you're surveying. Only later on in the evening, when you download your instrument to a computer and look at it on the screen, do you see the subsurface features revealing themselves? Having employed our geophysical survey, we can more than double the number of monuments now on the Hill of Terra.
But his greatest discovery would revolutionize our understanding of Terra.
I think the most exciting feature we found on the Hill of Terra is this vast oval enclosure on the northern side of the hill, encompassing right at the Sanitated Center, St. Patrick's Churchyard, and the Mound of the Hostages. We now know that this represents a ditch, either side of which are two concentric timber circles. So we've called this monument, rather unimaginatively, the ditch of the circle.
What Joe had found was a huge monument, a ditch 6 meters wide and 3 meters deep, cut into the living.